earthy color maybe, but the feel of the painting. Mm. There's nothing sexual about this painting, but somehow I feel it's very intimate and sexy.
Mm. I'm seeing Ikenaga's works for the first time. But his bijinga is very popular around the world, having been used for many publication covers.
This is Yasunari Ikenaga's painting studio. Let's pay him a visit. Hello.
Konnichiwa.
Thanks for having us. This is Ms. Sasaki.
Nice to meet you. Thank you so much for having us today.
You have a model here.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Hello. Nice to meet you.
Are you working right now? Yes, if I can work just a little more. Well, if you don't mind...
Please go ahead
and...
Is it all right if we watch you work?
Ikenaga always paints with the model in front of him. They are not professionals. He only has a few women he likes to paint, and has drawn several works of the same person. Because it takes several months to complete one painting, he asks the model to visit his studio many times. Ikenaga was just 3 when he decided to become a painter. Through the years, his theme has always been beautiful women.
When you paint women, do you have any particular person in your mind? Because I feel like you're sending a sort of like a love letter or a message.
No. I like who I'm drawing, the girl in front of me.
So you don't think about other women?
You don't flirt with other women.
That's right. To be honest, I wish I could reach out and touch her. But instead, I just paint.
Do you think that she looks like yourself?
I think there's a resemblance, but she's much more mature looking than I am.
Yes, the painting does look more mature. All the women in your paintings are mature looking. Are they? Never thought of them that way.
The titles of Ikenaga's works always include the name of the women pictured. Natsuko, Mai, Emiko. All women who lead separate lives. But when they are drawn by Ikenaga, their individual lives disappear, and they become an abstract depiction of a beautiful woman.
Seeing a lot of your works, there's a certain style in all of them, this Ikenaga beauty. In that way, you're exactly like Utamaro. There aren't many Japanese painters today who draw solely bijinga.
Yes. Well, I was told once it was pointless to paint bijinga.
Really?
How has bijinga changed since the early 19th century, when Utamaro passed away? In the late 19th century, Kawanabe Kyosai combined a decorative style of ukiyo-e bijinga with the three-dimensionality of Western paintings. 20th century painter Kaburaki Kiyokata's Beautiful Woman reminds us of nostalgic Edo in an increasingly westernized Japan. At about the same time, Kyoto-born female painter Uemura Shoen was also pursuing the ideal beauty of Japanese women.
In the early 20th century, I think bijinga as an art disappeared. Until then, there were bijinga painters who carried on the ukiyo-e tradition. I believe Kaburaki Kiyokata and Uemura Shoen were the last two masters. After World War II, when Kiyokata and Shoen passed away, there were no successors.
I think it's because bijinga became complete in the early 20th century. Once something's complete, there's little room to add anything new. I think that's why painters quit drawing bijinga.
But now, I think manga and anime are carrying on the bijinga tradition. Bijinga lives on, not in paintings, but in different genres.
I agree. The bijinga style is very unique. The beautiful girls that appear in manga and anime all have unrealistic faces. They're symbolized. So modern young people can look at a character with pigtails and understand she's the baby of the group.
Ukiyo-e bijinga are also symbolized beauties.
I think it was the exact same thing back then. But I feel in modern Japanese art, so much emphasis is on sketching accurately that the tradition of symbolized bijinga couldn't be continued.
Professor Yamashita and Mr. Ikenaga both say that the tradition of bijinga lives on in manga and anime today. At first glance, they all look to have the same face, like they've been symbolized. But in this unique art, different hairstyles or clothes give the female characters individuality and emotion.
It's natural that men want to draw women. I'm the same. We draw women because we love them. That's how bijinga originated, and I'm going to keep doing what I think is natural, without thinking about trends in the art world.
When people call your works bijinga, do you feel resistance or does it make you happy?
Happy. Japanese painting has continued up to now by swallowing in new things. The tradition of bijinga lives on in manga and anime. But I think maybe the paintings are trying to swallow that again.
The longing of men created the symbolized female ideal. Now I understand. That's an important element in bijinga. So then, what do we women think about female beauty? I'm going to do a little research with girls of a younger generation.
Here I'm in one corner of a trendy shopping center.
If you look over there, do you see the booth and machines? Looks like very popular among teenage girls. So I'm gonna go and take a look what's going on there.
Hello.
Konnichiwa.
This print sticker machine magically grants every girl's beauty wishes. With a few taps on the computer, you can change your appearance just as you like it.
You touch this to change your skin color and eye size. Pale skin here and big eyes.
I had them alter my face to get it closer to their ideal beauty. They whiten my skin and make my eyes larger, like an anime character. Seems different from the beauty men like to see. But I found one commonality. Big eyes and pale skin, like an anime character. Similar to the beautiful women by men, there are certain symbolized beauty features. Do the two of you admire these features too?
Yes.
This is ideal?
I think so.
What do these beautiful women say to us? Kitagawa Utamaro's bijinga was popular with women of that era too. I'm sure it had to do with wanting to learn the latest trends. But maybe those symbolized features were elements of beauty that women desired as well. In our modern world, portraits are seen as depictions of a person's unique inner self. But bijinga is not about that at all. Still, the symbolized women in bijinga do make us think about beauty and its effects.
¥300 years ago, people could never imagine that women would enjoy creating this photo booth stickers, our modern version of bijinga. So I wonder, who defines woman's beauty? Man, woman, or artists?